Hello students, in our today's class we are going to study about the new chapter, fractions and decimals, chapter number 9 from your class 4 mathematics textbook.
You see this circle here. This circle is divided into two parts by this line, right? The circle is divided into two parts by a line, and one part of the circle is shaded. This part is shaded, right? Now how to represent this in a fraction? How to represent this? First you have to see how many parts are there. So how many parts are there? There are two parts. In which one part, there are two parts and one part is shaded, right? One part is shaded. So you can write this as, first you have to write here the shaded part, that is 1, and total number of parts is 2. So we call this as 1 by 2, 1 by 2. The fraction which represent the shaded part in the figure is 1 by 2. This is read as 1 divided by 2 or 1 by 2. Now see the second one. Here the circle is divided into how many parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, right? By two lines. The circle is divided into how many parts? 4 parts. And how many parts are shaded? One part is shaded. So you can write it as shaded part and total number of parts. So we read this as 1 divided by 4 or 1 by 4. See the next one. Here there are 1, 2, 3, 4. How many parts? 4 parts. The circle is divided into 4 parts and 3 parts are shaded. So you can write this as 3 by 4 or 3 divided by 4.
Identify the fractions represented by the figure on the left side and write in the space provided. See the first one, I had already explained you, there are two parts and one part is colored, so you can write it as 1 by 2. See the second one, there are three parts, right? 1, 2 and 3. Three parts and one part is colored, right? So we can write it as 1 by 3. 1 by 3, okay? 1 by 3. See the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many parts? 4 parts. Out of 4 parts, 3 part is colored, right? So it is 3 by 4. Last one. There are 4 parts and 1 part is colored. How to write this, children? It is 1 by 4. You write 1 by 4. 1 by 4. Okay. Identify the picture that represent the fraction by a right mark. First one is done already, 1 by 2 example is done. So let us move on to the next one. Fraction is 1 by 4. So first you have to see 4 parts. Here there are 4 parts, here there are 4 parts and here there are 4 parts. But how many parts are colored? Only 1. So this one is the right answer. See the second one. 3 by 4. So there are 4 parts. Here there are 4 parts. Here there are 4 parts. Here there are no parts. So this is the wrong answer. Then 3 parts are colored. Out of 4, 1, 2, 3 is colored. So this is the right answer. So 1 by 3. So first you have to see 3 parts. 3 parts. Here 1, 2, 3. Okay. Here there are only 2 parts. So this is the wrong answer. Here there are 3 parts but they are not equal. So this is also the wrong answer. So right answer is A. See the last one. 2 by 3. So we must have 3 equal parts. Here there are 3, here there are 3 and here there are 3. Right? And how many parts are colored? 2. So this is the right answer. Exercise 9.1. Complete the following. Color 1 by 4. So there are 4, you have to color one bird. Okay. Use the crayons and color this bird. color for 1 by 2. So there are 2, you have to color 1. Okay, you have to color 1. Color 3 by 4. There are 4, you have to color 1, 2 and 3. Color 2 by 3. There are 3, you have to color 2. Encircle the fraction that represent the given picture. So you see here 1, 2, 3, 4. How many parts are there? 4. How many parts is colored? 1. So the answer is 1 by 4. You see here. Second one. How many parts are there? 3. How many parts is colored? 1. So this is the right answer. Shade the next picture to represent the fraction 1 by 3. That means you have to color or shade 1. There are 3 parts you have to color or shade 1. If you are coloring, use crayons. Do not use sketch pens. Okay. See this picture. There are 4 equal parts and 1 part is shaded. So I can write the fraction as 1 by 4. Correct? I can write it as 1 by 4. Now, what does 4 indicate here? So 4 is the total number of equal parts, right? Total number of equal parts. And what does 1 indicate? 1 is the colored portion or the shaded portion, right? So we read this as 1 by 4, 1 by 4. So here we call this 1 as the numerator. Okay, we call this 1 as the numerator and 4 as the denominator. We call it as denominator. Okay, so this represents the number of equal parts selected, colored or shaded. This represents total number of equal parts in which a whole object is divided. Now this is a whole part. Yes, this is the whole part is divided into 4 equal parts and in which one part is colored or shaded. That one part is the numerator and the equal parts of the whole object is the denominator. So I consider this circle as the whole part. This is the whole part. Okay. Now I will divide into 2 parts. Those 2 parts are equal. This part is equal to this part. So then I will shade one of the part. That means I can say that one of the 2 equal parts is shaded. So that's why it is 1 by 2. 1 divided by 2. So numerator by denominator. So fraction means fraction is always equal to numerator divided by denominator. Okay. So fraction is always equal to numerator divided by denominator. Which is the fraction that represents the shaded portion in the figure? It is 3 parts. 2 parts are shaded. So it is 2 by 3. What does 2 and 3 represent? Here 2 is, you have tried numerator, and 3 is denominator. Okay, denominator. Similarly, you see here 1, and these 2 problems you have to solve by yourself. John's father bought a small cake for his birthday. It was cut into 8 equal parts. You can see it. The cake is cut into 8 equal parts. One part is given to John. 2 parts are given to Revati. Rahim took 3 parts. Now 8 equal parts, 1 to John, 2 to Revati, 3 to Rahim. How many will remain? 2. Now answer these questions. Number of equal parts into which the cake was divided by John's father is 8. Parts of cake taken by John is 1. Part of cake taken by Revati is 2. Part of cake taken by Rahim is 3. Here, what does 1, 2, 3 represent? They are numerators, right? Numerators. What does 8 represent? 8 is the denominator. Now you have to see the picture and write the fraction. Okay, you see here 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 parts and 2 are colored, right? Yes. So 2 is the numerator, 4 is the denominator. 2 by 4 is also can be written as 1 by 2. Okay, is also equal to 1 by 2. Here you see there are 4 parts and 3 are colored, so it is 3 by 4. So the next you have to write your numerator and denominator. Then see the next one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 parts and 3 are colored. See the next circle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 parts and how many are colored? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.